We are also joined in by Mr. P.S. Jayaramu. Professor P.S. Jayaramu is head of
Yes.
department. Professor, thank you for joining on this program.
Thank
We
you.
have on this program, we have the editor of the New Indian Express herself, Ms. Santhana Bhattacharya. We also have Ms. Ramu Patil from Bangalore. So, you know, when you look at this, do you, before I come to you, Professor, well, but one question is, now will the NDA have to swear in somebody as prime minister? Because can someone pull the carpet from under their feet, so to speak? Because some of their allies could shift loyalty. So there is some kind of a pressure building up that someone has to be sworn in as prime minister.
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Thank you. I am very happy to join the discussion. In fact, in one of our groups called Dialogue, I had said it in the morning itself around 12:31 that, Prime Minister Modi himself should gracefully make way for someone else. Because, he had publicly announced that the party would get 370 and the NDA would get 400. More than that, the party had said all along that in all the 543 candidate constituencies, it is Modi who is the candidate, and we are fighting on Modi's name. So if you go by that statement, out of 543, in a way Modi has lost in 200 40 constituencies or things like that. So that is something which also has to be borne in, though of course they had said it rhetorically, but then that is also a fact in a way. So I am one of those who think that it would be nice if Prime Minister Modi himself articulates the opinion that someone else should lead the NDA. That's one thing. Second thing is that's
yeah,
one thing.
quickly,
just let me come
professor
to...
Pro professor
yeah.
just 1 second, ma'am, your quick take on that, on Mr. Modi. Now he's still the prime minister, so
yes,
how do you see, do you think he needs to be sworn in as prime minister? Do you think someone needs to be sworn
There
in
are
as prime minister?
Already moves to that effect. I doubt that there is going to be a change of guard immediately. Maybe 2 years down the line, but not now. I don't think so.
No. I mean, let me say one thing. I also think that the change may not take place. But I was just expressing an opinion, by the fact that Prime Minister had publicly said we will win 370 and the NDA 400 and all that. And now we also know that in his own home state, Uttar Pradesh, the party has done very badly. And it has not been able to do well in West Bengal. And in Maharashtra, the party, BJP should reflect on what they did, like dividing the
it has not gone down well.
It has not gone well. So people in the party, including Mr. Narendra Modi, should think about these things and arrive at some kind of a decision whether it would be nice to continue with him or bring somebody. That's one thing. Second thing is the allies themselves. If JDU is going to be, of course, it's already an ally. If JDU comes forward, and then TDP also joins, and if they send feelers that look, we would be comfortable working with a new leader and things like that, that is something which the party will have to think in terms of. I'm not saying it will happen tomorrow, but then that is something which cannot be ruled out. And I have also heard and read that there is a lot of discontent within the party, unexpressed discontent, because nobody could talk off and things like that. So all that might surface, and we don't know. But right now, since BJP is the largest party in the that has won the seats, the president will invite the leader of the largest party, that is Mr. Narendra Modi, to come and form the government at that stage. And she might give them a few days' time, 3, 4, 5 days, or whatever it is, one week. So during that time, what kind of a stand the party will take remains to be seen.
Yeah. Yeah, but there is also this talk that the Karnataka leaders are reaching out to Chandrababu Naidu. Ramu, how much of that is true? Have you heard anything on that?
Yes, ma'am. Sources are saying senior Karnataka leaders are reaching out to both Chandrababu Naidu as well as Nitish Kumar to get them on their side. I think the moment results started trickling, both sides, I think, dialing up Naidu and Nitish Kumar seems to be the most sought after leaders now. I think, that's what we've been told, ma'am. The sources in Congress are saying senior Congress leaders here are reaching out to them.
Of course, Sharad Pawar has denied that he has spoken to anybody yet. But it is quite significant that yesterday, before the polls are announced, Mr. Modi had a meeting with Nitish Kumar in Delhi. And we were told that, off the record, that our reporters were coming and telling us, our BJP correspondent was coming and telling that there was a talk about, railway ministry or agriculture ministry going to Nitish's JDU. But now, they'll be very, very crucial, both of them. Crucial for the survival and functioning of the government, because BJP clearly does not have the majority on its own.
Yes, ma'am. I remember discussing with you, ma'am, when you were in Bangalore that, during Vajpayee's time, Chandrababu Naidu used to be the most prominent politician in Delhi. Delhi, everything revolves around him. Maybe I think we are going back to that kind of scenario where an NDA is really NDA and Naidu being at the Naidu now, this is Nitish and Naidu being at the having a leverage over the government. One thing is for sure now, this government won't be like the previous government. This will be truly a NDA government with allies having more power or demand over BJP in terms of portfolio allocation or grants, special status, the policy formation, so many things.
Yeah, if Professor, BJP, you're saying something.
Yeah, I just wanted to join this debate. We all heard over TV channels, I don't know how far it is reliable and all that, that Chandrababu Naidu has already been talked to by the BJP leadership. And he has asked for 48 hours time. So he may like to, weigh the options. And you never know. He has not been an ally he has been an ally only in Andhra Pradesh. So he might like to weigh his options and then give his word. I wrote somewhere this morning in my tweet saying the three N's are going to be very important. Naveen Patnaik, Naidu, and then,
Nitish.
Nitish, you see. So the three N's might make their own subtle demands, you never know. And Naveen Patnaik is very hurt. I mean,
out of the reckoning in any case now.
No. That's precisely the reason why he might join. He might join, the India coalition kind of thing.
No, he was always there with them without the support of Naveen Patnaik and Jagan Mohan Reddy and Vice and BRS sometimes. They would not have been able to pass some of their legislation in Rajya Sabha.
Yes, okay. That's right. I understand.
So they were very crucial to their overall scheme of things, and that's the most interesting part, because this time it looked like from the exit poll is where we began the discussion. From the exit poll, it looked like that Modi has the last two elections finished off Congress. Now he's going and finishing off the regional parties. If those results held true, but that is not how it has happened. Some of the regional parties have risen up again, and some of them have been able to defend their territories. But his old allies, which is Naveen Babu, Jagan Mohan Reddy, and ADMK, has really suffered. That's a point to be noted.
Yes, that's really a point to be noted. But I was only trying to say, these are all speculations. Naveen Babu might, think in terms of switching sides. You never know. See. If the India Alliance is able to cobble up a majority or ask him to support and all that, that's how he might. May or may not. The situation is quite fluid. That's all we can say right now. Anything can happen. He might be with the NDA itself. He might even think in terms of supporting the India coalition, if at all, they stake their claims to form the government.
Right.
Thank you, ma'am. Really.
Thank you. Bansi?
Yeah. So we come to the very end of this program. Thank you for joining us on this.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.